with more than 35 nations, 30,000 people, and a million components working together, we share one simple goal: to illuminate the way to new energy. Since the dawn of time, human beings have owed everything to the almighty sun that shares its light with all life on Earth. But now, a group of 35 nations, representing more than half of the world's population, is closer than ever to unlocking the secrets of the star's source of energy, hydrogen fusion, which could deliver a clean, safe, and virtually unlimited power supply to humankind for millennia to come. But the way of the sun is fraught with shadow. To succeed, ITER and its seven primary members, China, the European Union, India, Japan, South Korea, Russia, and the United States, must overcome some of the greatest scientific challenges ever conceived and execute one of the grandest political collaborations ever dreamed. Through the shadows of all doubt, we're building a sun on Earth. So after decades of design and preparation, 2020 marks the long-awaited launch of ITER Assembly.
It's no secret that the world needs energy. We also know that the impact of the last 150 years or so of using fossil fuels has been increasingly devastating. And there's a big contest as to whether we can slow down in our consumption or we can find something to replace it with a cleaner alternative. Fusion has some unique characteristics that make it pretty much the absolute perfect energy source. Unlike fission, there is no possibility of a meltdown. If the reaction stops, everything just stops and that's it. It's really hard to do though. With fusion, we're reproducing the energy that's in the core of the sun and all the stars. We do it by creating a metal cage, and within that metal cage, an invisible magnetic cage that will confine what we call a fusion plasma. The idea of magnetic confinement we've been doing for roughly 60 years, building bigger and bigger tokamaks, and finally we've gotten to this. So the ITER project, 35 countries working together for the first time to build an industrial scale machine.
What I think it very much resembles a theater. Downstairs is the central stage, and then we have all these port openings here, port cells. They remind me of theater boxes where the Empress and the Emperor sort of waved at their people. I think we will not be able to stand here and to wave at ITER. This is certainly going to be a big theater for mankind. We have 150 million degrees inside the core of the plasma. We have 12 Tesla magnetic forces. We have currents in the system of 15 mega amps. So whatever number, figure you look at within ITER, it's big.
Without our members, we can't progress. We need them to believe and be committed throughout this really long project. It's lasting many, many years. So how do you stay committed to something? You have to stay well informed. You have to see what the progress is. So we go out, we do presentations, we meet people from the research community, from industry, policymakers. Everyone has an open invitation to come here and get a worksite tour and learn more about the project. We welcome this because it will help us reach new audiences.
You know, back in Japan, maybe people don't know about ITER, but they're interested, definitely. I have many friends here, many colleagues, and they're doing like great job. They're hardworking every day, morning to evening. But I think, you know, we communications team have the responsibility to spread their effort using social media, outreach.
As energy needs continue to build, we want the next generation to understand how fusion energy can be important. So we bring thousands of kids here every year to actually tour the site. We also try to bring in a lot of journalists. You're seeing a lot more press about ITER these days. There are literally hundreds of factories and laboratories, thousands and thousands of people around the world on multiple continents contributing their ideas to this project to try to change the future of human society.
You know, I'm just an intern student, but like somehow I'm trying to contribute to this like biggest project in the world. This could change the human history. It's great to do this job.
Everybody knows why we are trying to achieve fusion energy, but to sit in the cafeteria or in the canteen and to see all these different nationalities coming together to deliver a new source of energy that can really help us find a solution to prevent our own extinction.
Join us each week as we share the stories of the entire ITER endeavor. Not just the amazing machine and the incredible science, but the hardworking people who bring ITER to life right now. Thanks for sharing, and remember, as a publicly funded project, ITER belongs to all of us, so we could not do this work without you. Thanks again, and see you next time on ITER Now.